Welcome to a new colouring video. In this video I'm going to be testing out some art supplies in the new colouring book by Johanna Basford called World of Flowers. I've already done a review and flip through video if you want to watch that to see all the different pages. I'll leave a link up in the top corner there. If you just click the eye, there'll be a link to that video. Okay, so I'll just start with some polychromos. Yeah, so there's a nice bit of tooth to the paper, but not too much. And then you can get a really good, full, deep coverage with a bit of pressure. Get lots of layers. Layers absolutely brilliant. There's just enough tooth there to add loads of layers. Yeah, so they work brilliant, polychromos. Now I'm just going to try these Gold Faber by Faber-Castell. So these are kind of like a student level pencil. Just try these. Seem to work just as well. And then we can get a nice rich colour. These are really nice. These are layer and lovely as well. Lots of layers. So it's really good paper for pencils. Okay, so now for the Prismacolor. Yeah, just worked brilliantly. Absolutely no complaints at all. Just do a few layers. Those. Brilliant. Okay, now I'm going to try some of the Derwent Pro Colour. Because these aren't the best pencils to use in colouring books, so I'm just going to test on this paper to see how well they do. They're looking quite good so far. The problem for me with these Pro Colours was it was very difficult to get a deep colour. Can you hear that squeaking? It's like it doesn't want to take any more of that. It's like they're a little bit waxy. I'll just do the layer test. Yeah, they do layer. They don't layer as. They're not layering as well as the others, unfortunately. So now I'll move on to some wet media. So I'll start with some watercolour pencils, and I'm going to start with the Derwent Inktense, and then we'll see if it seeps through onto the back. So I'm putting plenty of water on to get it quite wet. Okay, that hasn't seeped through so far. Okay, so now for the Albrecht Dürer watercolour pencils. And I'm putting quite a lot of water on this again. And that hasn't seeped through. You can see here where the water from the Inktense is kind of buckling the paper a little bit, but of course that's just normal. As long as the colour hasn't come through, which it hasn't, that's fine because that'll dry and it'll dry a lot smoother. So it's pretty safe to say all watercolour pencils are the same, so whatever type you've got, if you've got watercolour pencils, they'll be fine. So I'm pretty sure normal watercolour will be fine as well, but I'll just test it. Okay, so next I'm going to try the Zig Clean Colour Pens. And a little bit of water to them. Okay, I wouldn't use these on this paper because it's just staining too quickly. It's very difficult to then blend it afterwards with water. As you can see, some of the colour's coming off, but it's leaving a line. So I would put a layer of the Satin Glazing Liquid by Golden underneath these to prevent that happening. Okay, so now I'll try some gel pens. Now I only have these cheapy ones, but I'll just do a little block of each because I very rarely use gel pens. So just do a little solid block of each colour and see if it soaks through to the back. Okay, I'll just have a look at the back of the page now. Okay, so nothing I've used so far has soaked through. Some of the water, like I said, has just buckled the paper a little bit, but none of the colours have soaked through. So next I'm going to try some of the Arteza gouache, which is an opaque watercolour. I'm sure it'll be fine, but we'll just test it anyhow. Okay, so I'll give that a minute or so to see if it's soaked through. And it hasn't, it's fine. Okay, so now I'm gonna try some alcohol markers, which probably will soak through. Yep, come right through. Let's see here. So they're not good. And then I think the last thing I've got to test is some water-based markers. Then I've got a Winsor and Newton one here. Just have a little look at that. And no, they haven't come through. So basically, the only thing that I don't think you can use in this book is alcohol markers, because obviously the print's on the back of the page, and the Zig Clean colour. If you're just going to use them neat, like I used these just neat and I didn't try and water them down, then that's absolutely fine. But if you want to blend that out with water, then it's not going to work on the paper, so you would need a primer. And the primer that I use is the Satin Glazing Liquid by Golden, and it's not actually supposed to be a primer, but it works really well with water-based products. Okay, so I hope you've enjoyed the video, and thank you very much for watching.